Now let us find out biggest number. This is one small example. I am illustrating some of the instructions like compare instruction, then rearrange instruction, and with this we are having some set of numbers. Then from that set, if you want to find out the biggest number, then we can use this simple logic. So here we are taking the advantage of compare instruction. Basically, compare jump if not equal to instruction. General format of this instruction, as all of you know, that it is having destination operand, source operand, and whatever you have, like the target address, relatively, that is the relative address, then the destination address and destination contents and the source contents are compared, and based on that carry flag is getting affected. Like destination is greater than or equal to source, then carry flag is 0, and destination is less than source, then the carry flag is 1. So this particular feature we can use in this program. Simply what I have taken is one address pointer I have declared in the beginning, that is move R0, 40H. So from 40 onwards we will be storing some set of numbers. So say for example, here I have used counter as 5. Second instruction, move R1, 5. So 5 numbers we will be having. Then move B, 0H. So for compare instruction, any register or any say from RN set register you can use, and you can compare that with immediate data also. Here what I am doing, instead of keeping there in the, as a part of compare instruction, immediately comparing with 0, I am storing that 0 with in some register, that is a simple register I am using here, B, and I will be setting that register for the comparison purpose. Why I have used here 0, because I want to find out biggest number, so I will focus on carry. Now if suppose my number from the address pointer is transferred into accumulator, so accumulator will be having one number, and then I will compare it with say, first of all, in the first iteration, first step, with 0. So if accumulator is positive number, that is a greater number than 0, destination is greater than 0, then carry will not be set, and if destination is less than 0, then carry will be set. So what I am doing, I am checking whether carry is set. If carry is set, so means my accumulator is having small number and the B register is having big number, so I am restoring that and proceeding further. And if carry is not set, meaning is that accumulator is having smaller number and B register is having bigger number, so at that time accumulator is having bigger number and B register is having smaller number, at that time I am transferring those accumulator contents to B register, and then I am proceeding. By the end of the program, what I am doing is I am sorting out this bigger number and transferring it continuously in every iteration, in the comparison results in the carry bit. Based on that status, I am transferring bigger number into B register, sorting that bigger number in every comparison. I begin with comparing with 0 because I want to check the status of the carry. Exactly reverse we will have to follow whenever we will be comparing it for finding out smallest number. So at that time our destination and source comparison, so we want in the B register, say for example, smaller number we want to sort out, then we should compare it with FF. So instead of JC, we will go for JNC and we will compare it with FF. So simple task. Now here I will show you how exactly it is to be done. So first instruction, move R0, #40H will point to address. Then R1, #5 is a counter. Then move B, #0 is for reference, say, or we will call it as a kind of a threshold for switching from based on the carry for decision making. Now I have written here move A, @R0. What is the meaning? @R0 means from that address whatever is the data it will take, and it will copy it into accumulate. And the next instruction is compare it with B. Now in the beginning when our loop starts, B is containing 0, 0, so that is 0. Suppose in accumulator first number, any number is there, say number 3 is there, then 3 is destination, B is containing source. So if destination is smaller than source, then carry will get generated. If destination is greater than source, carry will not get generated. Suppose in the first pass, when we are comparing with 0, so at that time already accumulator is bigger than B, that is 0. So therefore, there will not be any carry generated. Okay. So therefore, whatever accumulator contents are there, those are getting transferred into B register. R0 is incremented, counter is decremented, D is ANZ, and it will go back to take the next number. You can see here. So one by one just here. So in this comparison, so it will go back. Now if in the second pass, now suppose our new number we are taking in A, and our old number which was bigger than 0 by default, first number, so that was in that has been copied in B register. So because of that, what will happen? Now B is having one number, A is also having another number. A is having second number, B is having first number. Now if, say for example, our first number was 6 and second number was second number is say 3. So what is happening now? A is having small number, that is 3, and B is having first number which was transferred due to the carry status, that is that since there was no carry, so therefore that was transferred, and B is containing 6. So since now the carry is generated, destination and source, destination is smaller, with carry it will go to directly this loop 1 and it will increment because already B register is having bigger number. So in this fashion, one by one it will proceed. Here you can see, then once it is all over, all the comparisons are done, then finally it will reach to final biggest number is in B, and that is copied into accumulator, and that result is stored at the address 50H. So we will do single stepping so that we will better understand how the numbers are getting transferred. Very simple logic. So first of all, I will once again save, then I will rebuild it. Already done. Just to save time, I have done this. Now in this program, I will show you from memory how to get the data. So start debug. So our address is 40H. So here in the memory window, 40H we will get. This is option from view. There is a memory window. You can point to that particular window. When we click on this memory window, window will get open, and whatever address in the program you have given from the data memory, so you put there D colon and whichever address, like here in the beginning I have given 40H, so that is to be given here. So now one by one we will give the numbers. So come here to the first position, right click, modify memory, here give one number, suppose my number is 5, ok. Now go to second position, right click, give the number, say for example 8, now ok. Then the third position, right click, give the number, say 2, okay. Then fourth position, right click, give the number, say for example I'm giving 8, I think 8 already I have given, so we'll give 9, okay. And now the fifth number, right click, modify, I will give here one number, say 3. Okay, so 5 numbers I have given. Fine. See here, our numbers are 05, 08, 02, 09, 03. Intentionally, I have given one small number, big number, small number, big number, like that, so that you will be able to understand in single stepping effect of how exactly A and B are getting interchanged. A register and B register. Here you can see that. So, we'll go on doing single stepping. First step, see here R0. Now come to here in single stepping. 40, R0 is pointing to 40. Next, now R1 is containing the counter, that is 05. Next, now it will go to that green bar also in the single execution, single step execution you see. So it is proceeding further. First number is taken. Our first number is 5. See here in accumulator there is a first number. So next, it is just proceeded. It has compared it with 0. Next, since already accumulator is containing the bigger number, so carry is not generated. So therefore, just see that green bar also you see here how it is. Then next, so now what is happening? Since carry is not generated, it will come here. JC, if carry is there, then it is going to loop 1. Okay, that is our relative address, directly going to increment the counter address pointer. But carry is not generated, so whatever is in A now, that is copied in B. See here, A was containing first number 5, that is copied in B. Now just see, address pointer is incremented, 41. Next, so counter is decremented, 04. Next, now it has taken the second number, so second number is 08. Now accumulator is containing 08 and B register is containing 05. So proceed. What is happening? Just see. Now accumulator is bigger, B is smaller. Next, once again there is no carry, so therefore contents of accumulator are transferred into B. So between first two numbers 5 and 8, 8 is bigger number, that has been transferred to B register. Continuously B register is taking bigger number, it is holding that particular number. So next, in pointer incremented, 42. Next, counter is decremented, address pointer incremented, counter decremented, next number is taken. Next, now accumulator is containing 2, B register is containing 8. So now just see, accumulator is having smaller number, B register is having bigger number, so there is no need to transfer. What is happening? See here, even you can monitor the PSW register, so carry flag is set. You can see here, now the carry is set because A is smaller. So just see, B is already 8, A is 2. There will not be any interchange. You can see from A to B, this instruction, move A to B, this instruction will not get executed because of this carry generated. Directly it is coming to increment address pointer. Just see now, A is as it is 2 and address pointer is incremented. Just see here, A and B. Now the next number is taken. Next number, accumulator has taken now 9, and again now the accumulator is bigger, so therefore there is no carry, so therefore there has to be transfer from A to B. Just see here. Okay, that A09 is now transferred to B register. Since here in the loop it will go, since they see no carry because A is bigger, 9, B is 8, and now it will proceed. So B has been now transferred, changed as 9. And next memory pointer, your counter last number, that is 03, is taken. Again now the accumulator has become smaller, so already B is containing bigger number, there is no need to interchange, therefore it will proceed. You can see next address pointer, counter is has become 0, so it will come here directly. Now A is also containing 9 and B is also containing 9, that is your bigger number. Over. You can see here address, just see. So 50 was the address given in our program, so that was for this assembly we don't want. So here from 40 address we have stored 5 numbers, and address 50 is taking the showing you the biggest number. Exit. Getting this very small straightforward execution for finding the biggest number. Now just see, if you want to find out smallest number, what changes you will do. First of all, I will stop debug. So instead of carry bit JC, the loop, same loop I want to repeat. So just here you can make change, small change, that is JNC, and instead of comparing with 0, because now if we keep it 0, it will not work, because we want to have the same logic, that is the sorted number we want to transfer to B register, and for decision making, for biggest number our 0 was the reference, but for smallest number, since accumulator contents if are smaller, then we want to sort, then we want to transfer it to B. So therefore we will keep in the first pass, because in the first pass, if suppose we keep B register 0 and accumulator contents whatever number is there, so with respect to that 0, in the first pass itself accumulator will be bigger and that will get copied into B register. We don't want that. We want that accumulator has to be having when smaller number, then only there should be transfer from accumulator to B register. So as to get this, we should make in the first pass B register FF for finding smaller number. So therefore we will make it 0. Understood? Just be very particular. If we are going to keep B register 0, and once again if for smaller number we are doing the same exercise, then what will happen? There will be change. So 0 will get compared with any number in the accumulator. Always A will be bigger, and therefore that A will get copied into B register. But we don't want to copy bigger number. We want to copy smaller number. For smaller number execution, now forget about comments for time being. This is the execution which I am showing you for smaller number. So therefore the changes I made for smaller number JNC, and the reference is 0FFH. Same process. So once again same thing we will repeat. Save, debug, and start. So here now you have to give once again the numbers. One disassembly. Want this only. Just give the number. Right click. Modify. 4 number 6. Okay. Second number, modify, this is say 3, okay, next, right click, modify, here is 2, okay, next, right click, modify, there is suppose 8, okay, and this is right click, modify, say 4, okay, fine. Now what we'll do, single stepping. Just see, quickly I will do now. Address pointer 40, counter 5, R0 and R1 status, you monitor, it is here. Then single stepping, so B register is loaded with FF. Now it will compare accumulator contents. Accumulator is smaller, so it is to be copied into B register. Okay, just see, shear effect, B register is changed. Accumulator is copied into B register only when accumulator is smaller. So therefore I have taken B register reference as FF. Next, then next, second number is 3. Now again accumulator is smaller, so there will be interchange. Getting what we are doing? If no carry, then we are proceeding further. If carry, we want carry here because we want to get smaller number to be sorted out. So next, number is now counter incremented, sorry decremented. Next number is taken 2, third number. Comparison, still it is a smaller one. So again it is transferred. You can see here in B register status, continuously small. If it is a smaller number than accumulator, then only it is getting transferred. Then next number is in last number 8. There is no interchange because already accumulator is contained, sorry, B register is containing smaller number. Last one 4, still a B register is containing smaller number. So since it is a smaller number, it will not get changed because of A content. So finally the smaller number is separated out. Over, yes, just see at the 50 address, smaller number. Getting? So this is finding smaller or bigger number with the help of CJNE instruction. I will once again make the changes according to biggest number, because my title is biggest number, and those who are going to refer this video, I don't want to confuse them unnecessarily. For smallest number, whatever we need to change, I have mentioned already two small changes I have done, that is JC and JNC. Once again I will repeat in a moment. For finding biggest number, we have taken one register B, where in the beginning I have stored 0, and using CJNE instruction, which is having format destination, comma source, comma relative address. So when destination is smaller, carry generated. When destination is bigger or equal than source, carry is not generated. So this feature we have used, and always what we have done, the bigger number after the comparison between A and B, we have transferred to B register based on the carry status. So JC, that is when carry is generated, indicating that accumulator is smaller, so it will directly go to INC R0 instruction. In the loop you can see, so that is indicating that whenever carry is generated, it means B is already containing bigger number, so it will proceed counter decremented and so on. And whenever accumulator is bigger, so when carry is not generated, it will go here, next instruction below JC, and accumulator contents are transferred to B register. Then the address pointer is incremented and counter is decremented. So just we have seen 40 onwards, we have stored the set of numbers, and 50 at H, we are observing the result. So this is all about biggest number. Thank you.